Hello, Penn High School, and welcome back to PNN. I'm Meg Durrell.
And I'm Cora Estrada. Today is Friday, May 4th.
On Monday, April 30th, a student was suspected of having a gun at school. The St. Joseph County Police Department investigated the student's home, and they found and confiscated the gun off the property. Since the Parkland School shooting, schools across the nation have been upping their security, and the PHN district is no different. PNN reporter Lindsay Zimmerman got a look into Penn High School security precautions.
School safety across the country is more prevalent than ever with the recent school shootings. Penn High School is taking action to prevent a tragedy from happening.
A number of years ago, we coordinate with our law enforcement agencies, with our fire departments as well, and with our hospitals to conduct exercises for active shooter prevention. Now, those exercises are to assist law enforcement, schools, and firemen in a cohesive effort to respond. But what we want to do is we want to get in front of those situations. We don't want to let it play out, so we try to get in front of it. And we talk about, if you see something, say something.
Penn High School Principal Mr. Gallagher and Associate Principal Mr. Williams have been making changes at Penn to ensure safety.
I'd like to make sure that all students and staff are aware that we are making changes as to how students access the building in the morning. This is a vital moment in our day that we must improve upon. We need to differentiate between students, visitors, and unauthorized people entering our school. We have purchased a new ID for every student to begin with. Wearing an ID tag lets school and staff know that you belong in the building. We have several thousand students showing up every day, and it would take just one person sneaking in to compromise the safety of everyone. You must wear your ID where a staff can see it. Your teachers will be checking and asking for compliance. We will check to make sure you are wearing it throughout the day, including to gain access to the cafeteria. This is one simple expectation that you can meet to show your support for ensuring that the school is a safe place. Please consider this a call to action. We are all in this together.
Penn students Nathan Wallace and Lana Sirachin present differing opinions on the ID policy.
I don't think it's really good because, you know, like, come in the building, the security guards barely look at your IDs, you know. Like, I could get a fake ID or my friend's ID and then just walk in the building. They wouldn't even take a look at it.
I think it's like, we're taking the necessary precautions, so yeah, it's good.
Students at Penn voiced their opinions on school safety and gun violence with regards to arming teachers.
I mean, the thought of, like, being armed just scares me itself. I don't know. Not that I don't trust my teachers, it's just, I don't know. The thought of, like, having arms in schools, like, that just doesn't.
State Superintendent of Public Instruction for the whole state of Indiana, Dr. Jennifer McCormick, talked about how the state is taking steps to protect students.
So Indiana is very fortunate. We have a school safety academy. We're only one state in the nation that has it. So we're opening that up in May to invite all the states from across the nation to participate. Our governor's going to come. We've invited our General Assembly to come see the great things we're doing. But every school that attends that has a school safety specialist. So that is unique to Indiana. But we also run drills. I'm sure you're familiar with the drills that we have to run, which is those are very important. We also make sure schools have really great school safety plans, and those are quite extensive. So Indiana's got a lot going on in school safety. We're going to fight to get more resources, and that includes money, and we'll continue to have policy talks.
Safety and security of students is always a priority at Penn High School. Reporting for PNN, I'm Lindsay Zimmerman.
Thank you, Lindsay. Your safety is top priority to the staff at Penn High School. Always remember, if you see something, say something.
Seniors, if you have any extra lunch money in your account that you will not be using, you can either transfer, donate, or refund this money. To do any of these options with your extra lunch money, you will need to fill out the form that is located in the cafeteria.
And now, here's a sports update from the PNN sports team.
What's up, Penn High School? I'm Zach Comedine. I hope you've all been staying safe, and let's take a quick look into Penn sports. The reigning state champion softball team matched up and shut out John Glenn this past Tuesday, May 1st. The girls crushed Glenn with a score of 10-0. Contributors in the victory were Kylie Gray with 2 runs and 2 RBIs, Gabrielle Courtier with a run and an RBI, Brenna Brown with a run, Maddie Griman with a run and an RBI, Lexi Gray with a run, Jesse Bucky also had an RBI, Addie Coyce, Tori Budzinski, and Katie Adams all had a run apiece. The girls are 11-4 overall and 8-0 in conference. The girls play tonight, May 4th, at home versus Crown Point. Penn baseball is on fire. They're currently on a win streak of 6, and they have been nothing but domination. Their last loss was against Lake Central back in April. Their most recent game was against New Prairie, though, where they won by a score of 14-8. Penn is now 10-3 on the season. The Slugging Kingsmen are aiming to win their next game on Wednesday against the South Bend Adams. Boys golf has also been active lately, with a match at Elbow Golf Course this past Monday and a match at Knollwood this Saturday at 8. PNN reporter Justin Fox has more information. Justin.
Just before the Kepler Crown, the Penn Kingsmen boys golf team took on rivals St. Joe and Concord on their home course of Knollwood Country Club. Penn came out electric with 3 players shooting sub-40s to lead the Kingsmen to victory. Ben Sklerik led the pack with a 34, with Zach Hill and Grant Wargo finishing with a 37 and a 38. This energy continued to the crown. According to South Bend Tribune, Ben Sklerik shot 1 under par to bring the crown home. Reporting for PNN, I'm Justin Fox.
Thank you, Justin. Girls lacrosse played Fort Wayne Homestead on April 28th and won 19-16. They're now 6-3 on the season, and they play the St. Joe Indians on May 2nd at home at 6:30 p.m. It's senior night. A list of the seniors that will be playing that night are as follows. Abby Yoder as the manager, Abby Hamilton, Abby Cook, Veronica Kiergos, Maddie Brown, Katie Root, Kayla Walker, Jill Woods, Lindsay Schabel, and Kyle Warner. On May 1st, the girls' tennis team clashed with Northridge in a meet here at home on the YCAM courts. Penn won 5-0. Marley Kreider won her match against Northridge's Riley Wheatley 6-4 and 6-1. Sophie Davidson beat her opponent Victoria Oaks 6-1 and 6-3. Erin Ludwig took down Sarah Hartman 6-0 and 6-1. In the duos matches, Taylor Murphy and Reka Kovacs won against Peyton Kuiper and Bryn Gaylor 6-2 and 6-2. Finally, Allie Comfer and Aiden Moore beat Carly Schroeder and Amaya Guevara 6-1 and 6-2. The boys lacrosse team had a game against the Northridge Raiders this past Tuesday. This game was especially important for head coach Bo Islayeb, considering he used to coach for Northridge. Early on, things didn't look hot for the Kingsmen, who were down 1 going into the half. But scores from Andy Schuring, Jackson Lambert, and Kyle Palmer, as well as strong defensive stops from goalie Connor Fisher and long pole Josh Aluska and the rest of the defense, helped propel the Kingsmen to a 10-7 win. This Saturday, the boys travel to Garin Catholic for what should be a big test for the Kingsmen. That looks like all I got for you today. I'm Zach Comedy, and wishing you a good week, Penn High School.
Thanks, guys. Visit our website, pnn.phmschools.org, for more updates on all of Penn's spring sports.
Also, if you are a senior who has not filled out the transition form, then you need to fill it out ASAP. It is mandatory for you to be eligible to graduate and should only take a few minutes to fill out.
This summer, in sunny, shiny, and warm Fort Lauderdale, Mr. Starkweather is taking his speech team to compete in nationals. PNN reporters Dylan Hyjema and Jesse Olvera bring you more.
Livia Lee, a sophomore at Penn High School, is preparing to head to Fort Lauderdale, Florida to compete in the Speech and Debate National Competition in the Domestic Extemporaneous category. She had to go through the district and state competitions to qualify for the national competition. Her coach, Jeremy Starkweather, is a teacher at Penn High School and a first-year speech and debate coach, and he is already sending her to nationals. Starkweather said Lee has worked hard for this competition and has a future in speech and debate. Lee told us a little bit about how the competition works and how she prepares to compete.
For qualifying for the national tournament, you have to go through the district's tournament first, which is basically a regional. The regional this year was 3 preliminary rounds, and then the top 12 people that had the best scores through those would go to the semifinals. And then after that, you'd do another round and then finals. So the top 2 people overall throughout the district's tournament advance. Right before I compete, I always like to make sure that I'm on top of the really recent events, such as if I have a tournament that day, then I want to wake up in the morning and check and see if anything else has occurred, just to make sure that I'm on top of the analysis. And I also want to make sure that I know what kind of evidence I have and what kind of reading that I've done, to make sure that when I do draw those questions, I can ensure that I have the proper answers and I'm prepared to answer those questions. Teammates are all relatively new because Penn has a relatively small speech team. It's pretty small, but it's a really tight-knit community. They've always provided each other, and me especially, with support, and I'd really appreciate them for doing so. We always have fun during practices, and we can also get serious when it comes to that. So I'm really proud of my team, and I'm really happy that I'm part of Penn's speech team.
Starkweather also gave us some comments on how the speech and debate competition season went and how Lee performed this year.
Livia Lee is only a sophomore, and she's already qualifying for nationals, which I think kind of says a lot about her. She's super smart, totally determined, hard worker. She's emailing me constantly with questions, and I think probably out of like many of my students, she's one of the most hard workers, and she totally deserves to go. So she's put forth the effort into this year, and I'm really excited to spend a week in Florida competing at the national tournament. So we actually had an awesome team. We had an awesome year. It's a ton of fun. We have a great group of people that we get to hang out every Wednesday with after school, and we read poetry and we speak and practice our public speaking every week. We had a couple pretty good success stories at our state competition. We had Gabby Bessie make it to the quarterfinals, and Anya Tang made it all the way to the semifinals as a freshman. And Livia Lee, in United States extemporaneous speaking, actually qualified for the national tournament this year in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. So that's pretty exciting.
Livia Lee, a sophomore, and newcomer Michael Riley, a junior, are 2 qualifiers from Penn High School to compete in the nationals competition. Follow Mr. Starkweather on Twitter for updates regarding the competition.
The speech and debate teams will be hosting a fundraiser at Chipotle on Monday, May 14th from 4 to 8 p.m. All you have to do is show the coupon that is located on Kingsman Nation, and 50% of the proceeds will go to debate and speech.
This Saturday, Penn will be hosting the 13th annual Silver Mile Run. Here is PHM Superintendent Dr. Jerry Thacker with some more information.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jerry Thacker, PHM Superintendent. What are you doing on Saturday, May 5th? I know what I'm doing. I'm participating in the Silver Mile 5K Bubble Bash. So what are you waiting for? Register now and let's go.
Thank you, Dr. Thacker.
Over the weekend, the Symphonic Orchestra and Winds competed in the ISMA State Qualifier competition. They were 1 in 8 high school orchestras selected to compete at the state competition. Congrats to everyone who competed.
Can you lick your elbow or stand on one hand? Then contact the yearbook to get yourself featured and have all your friends and see your cool or interesting talent. Have a great weekend. May the 4th be with you always.
Congratulations. I am here to proudly announce that of all the great teachers we have at Penn Harris Madison School of Preparation,
yeah,
that you have been named the 2018 Penn Harris Madison Teacher of the Year.
Truly, this is incredible. I do not feel like I deserve it because I work with such amazing people and I see that every day, but I am honored. I do love teaching. I love my students, and I can't imagine being anywhere else.
You know, it feels really great. She totally deserved it. I know all the work that she's put in, the 4 years that I've at least known her as part of the first cohort in early college. She's put in so much work and effort into the lessons plans, into getting these field trips, that like special field trips that we do. And we, as early college students, we feel just so appreciated being a part of the program, and we know that she deserves it.
She's always been very caring, and like no matter what, she's good at building relationships with her students. And even though school takes so much out of her, she always comes home and has conversations with us. She always asks us how our day went. She's just really caring overall.
She strives for the best at whatever she does. She's not happy until she feels like it's close to perfect, as close as possible. And then in the midst of all that, she's just fun. She's enjoyable, she's fun, she's got a good sense of humor, she's making jokes out of things to make it more fun, and I think her students embrace that.
I guess that my love for teaching and students shone through. I work really hard to have engaging lessons and to be there for my students holistically in English, and now this year in speech and through the theater, so I guess that's why.
We feel so blessed, just incredibly blessed to have her as a daughter, and she's a firstborn for sure.
Exactly. And I could see her, she loves teaching so much that I don't think she'll necessarily get out of teaching, but she also has skills in leadership and administration, so who knows? I think she'll take advantage of opportunities perhaps that come her way, but she won't want to get too far from the classroom.
Truly, I think what I'm most proud of is these students, and I've had the opportunity to loop with them, which is an incredible chance to be their teacher for 4 years and to see the growth and to see them overcome adversity and to be able to walk with them in that process has been really incredible.